understaffing still is a challenge.
According to Dr. Frank Chisache, a doctor at Kalangala Health Center, for every month, 7 premature babies are referred to Masaka Referral Hospital, of which only 2 survive the long travel from the island.
The patients being referred, they are constrained with their transport issues. They need finances. You know, water transport is very expensive. So it's one thing. The other thing, also the golden hour, the time you would save a neonate, the time you would save a mother from death, is reduced.
With the machines donated to the facility, Dr. Frank is hopeful it will help reduce the risks.
We have 2 health center fours in Kalangala district. That's Kalangala Health Center 4 and Bukasa Health Center 4. Apparently, Bukasa Health Center 4 doesn't have a medical doctor there. So all cases really which need to be addressed by a doctor, they are referred to here.
Annette Mutibwa, the Kalangala senior nursing officer, has revealed challenges faced by women who give birth to premature babies.
These women could look at us as people who are not empathetic while we refer them. So it has been a very big challenge on our side as midwives or service providers.
Despite receiving the medical equipment, the facility still has more challenges, as Dr. Frank explains.
Drug stockouts, infrastructure-wise, understaffing still is a challenge. However, we hope that with the Minister of Health and other IPs, this shall be addressed with time.
Diane Ondoga, the manager of Social Corporate Responsibility under Stanbic Bank, noted that they partnered with the Ministry of Health to reduce maternal deaths in Uganda.
Now, Kalangala has a unique challenge in terms of access to the referral hospital. So the machines that we have delivered today are to enable management of cases of prematures, cases of jaundice at this hospital.
The donated medical equipment cost 23 million shillings. Story by Samuel Nkuba for the news.